Hey guys. Okay, we're live. Awesome. Plan for the day is work on the iron farm again. I haven't done too much since last Sunday, I think was the last time I worked on it. And afterwards an AFK stream. It's gonna be a highlight of the whole quarry. Gonna take out the village. Yeah, I haven't streamed all week. I was busy mostly with the YouTube and my sports. I was extremely tired because of the weather in Germany. So, yeah. I wanted to stream, but just didn't have the energy. Hey, German. Thanks for 100 bits. Progress on the quarry is awesome. 900 and something blocks. 940. Ja. So, we're gonna work on the iron farm a little bit today, maybe 3 4 hours. And then AFK stream quarry again. This is gonna be the highlight. The village is gonna be taken out. I stopped it. Here was already a field in front of the village that already got destroyed, and now the whole village. Almost a third, then more like yeah, a fourth. Hey, Conny. Also, I have a bunch of villagers here. Added doors. Alright, but that's gonna be something for later. Did you figure out the problem? Nope. Still didn't figure it out. Has to be something with the fences and maybe gravel blocks, but we don't know. Alright, maybe we can also check out the storage while we're here. Haven't checked that for quite a while. Did it crash again? Yep. Again, it was near a mine shaft. But we still don't know why. Okay, how much we got? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, almost 12. So it is about, well, probably 4.5 million items again. So we have a fourth of the quarry and probably about 10 million items per now. Perfect. That's the second storage, yeah. So now I know, I think we built that actually on last stream. Gonna actually reach the point where the storage begins, so it's not that far away anymore. It's a rare mine shaft. Rail, water, fence, gravel. Nobody knows why it's happening. It has to be some kind of an odd constellation of blocks, and we haven't figured it out yet. What's the whole build about? It's about getting terracotta, mostly. Alright, but now let's leave the quarry behind. I'm gonna work on the iron farm again. Yeah, the big part of the iron farm I want to do is the chunk loading underground again. So a little bit of digging probably today and building another tunnel bore, make space. Also getting the villagers in. It's Ethos design. Today was the first cool day since weeks. This was so nice. Yesterday I couldn't sleep again. Yeah, I went to bed at around 3 a.m. Couldn't sleep until 5. Until finally it got cooler again and slept at 5 a.m. But yeah. didn't get a lot of sleep the last few weeks. Didn't buy an AC. Yeah, that's weird, it's the first time I've... Oh yeah, okay. What I did, I moved to the basement of my computer at least. So that's better. Sleeping is still... Yeah, in the heat. But I hope not a heat wave is over. Today we had mostly 18 to 22. It's supposed to get hotter again for 3 days and then it's gonna cool off again. But we had it now, I think, 2 or 3 weeks almost at 30 plus temperatures. Alright, Piston Bolt. Temps up to 45, oh god, can't even imagine. Thanks a lot, High Order Failure, for 3 months Steam resub. Oh yeah, the XCOM's music for the video was awesome, yeah. How many hours do I have on the SciCraft server? I think about 7,000? Yeah, quarry stopped. .87 years. Yeah. No, it's still 1.12. Do you know how long all the piston bolts are? I think we have about 30,000 blocks worth of piston bolt. Yep. That's why we're always worried in every update about the piston bolts, because if those will break at some point, yeah, that wouldn't be fun. Almost happened in 1.13, but luckily all our bugs got fixed. Okay. So that's the iron farm. Blue eyes, yeah, no, not a big fan. Also use the piston bolt. So that's Rago's project here. I think we have enough villagers. Awesome. Definitely looks like we have enough. Is this... I'm not sure how this works. What's the idea? Where can I get the villagers now? Looks like this chamber is for the... Well, I can take it out of here. Alright, let's say we go to Eater's world real quick and check how many we need in which spots. Iron... What was it? Stream... So I guess the satellite, you almost need a single one, yep, there's one. And here we probably have more, no, also one. At some point we need a bunch. Where is it? Also one here? Okay. Ah, those. Okay, here we need 20. Alright. Yeah, I guess we can build this. Hope we can find some raiders. Oh, thanks, Damon. Okay, regular. 40,000 bread. Not sure if that was necessary. What's the least favorite block? Hard to say. Don't like the granite too much. I'm just gonna dupe the rails real quick. Once we have any here. Yeah, that's just a farm for testing purposes if the chunk loading works. Yeah, also a few normal raiders. What causes rail duping? Yeah, update order pretty much. But all of an explanation what happens exactly, I would recommend to watch Myron's video. As far as I know, rail duping might be broken. Carpet duping still works. I just found this out today. You can even do some TNT duping still in 1.13.1. But it doesn't work with the rails anymore, so we basically need to place redstone dust every time. Alright, guess we have normal blocks somewhere. Didn't Radel steal away to dupe rails? I'm not sure. Don't follow what he's doing. But rail duping is really nothing special, I mean. Yeah, for example, we did know about the TNT tubing for months, but nobody posted a video for the clicks. We usually don't do that. That seems a bit odd. Why is the piston here? Is that supposed to be, did I do this wrong, or let's check this world again. Seems like you forgot to place that water. Okay. Yeah, I definitely use Optifun. I'd love to use a new Optifine rush at some point, so we're still at 1.12.0. But the newer version actually has the 64 chunk random distance. Should try that at some point. Oh, Pella storage. Sorry, no new news. I haven't heard from Pella in a while now. Not sure. Who's probably just busy, maybe lost interest. I really don't know. Hope he's just busy with university. As a villager can survive a little drop, right? Oh no, he actually is on minecart. Yeah. Doesn't matter anyway. It's been a while since I pushed villagers around, yeah, that's true. The last time I did this was... God, I don't think I even did it on Sidecraft. For an iron farm, probably my single player world at some point, like 4 years ago. I usually don't like working villagers. Oh yeah, should we get some iron for minecarts? We don't have that rule enabled now. Are we going to get the village out of the card? Probably just gonna pillar up from the side, break a block, break the minecart. Yeah, that should work. There were minecarts in the chest? Oh god. Totally didn't focus on that. That chest? Oh no, I mean the other one. No, I just brought a lot of iron because I need like 20 minecarts anyway. So, how do we get them out? Problem is, we have a lot of baby villagers in there. If I open up a block, they're gonna come storming out. But it might just kill them, because we have enough anyway. Make sure none survive. Could break the door detection. I actually don't know. I'm iron farm noob. But yeah. There won't be a leftover afterwards. So let's see if this works. I hope I just can push the minecart in and gets pushed back by the villagers. Let's see. Almost worked. Damn. Often when a minecart is stuck, a second minecart helps. No! Oh, that didn't help. Awesome. Have people seen Tango's village mod? I haven't. Wait, somebody claimed he did it on his own and said it would become 1.4. Oh god. Yeah. Awesome, got the first one in, which is 24 more. Okay. Let's go over there for the next one. Oh yeah, the story from Doc M, yeah. Pechschnitzel mit Wassermelone. Okay. I think I actually also got contacted by lock.zip at some point. Yeah. Don't think that would have worked out. Kind of wanted to cooperate somehow, but I don't think we need that publicity. We could use the offset placement to make the ramp up, but then I'm mostly standing in the way myself, so if we would try this, then I don't know. Can't get an angle there, where I wouldn't stand in the way of placing the block. Redstone blocks suffocate villagers? Quite sure. Better place it on the side. God, he can get a strike for clickbaiting? That is awesome. But I don't think they're that's really strictly enforced, because there's a lot of clickbait. Okay. Clickbait is so much channel was deleted. Awesome. Oh yeah, got it in there. Good. Really? What if we lose the villager? What? Was the pick or the dragon? What happened? Can baby villagers detect doors? I would assume, but I don't know. They usually do everything the normal villagers do. Harvest crops. Yeah. So. No, it didn't derail the card, it was just a client server desync again. I hope it doesn't run out immediately now when I break the card. Good. So So, what's the next one? Let's do that one. We need water on top of the farm too. What? What do I mean with water on top of the farm? So I definitely need to place a water bucket here. Oh, you mean here, for example? Yeah, yeah, sure. I also need to fill in all the inventory blocks still. Haven't done that, but apart from that. Oh, look, it's still clocking even. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, let's get all the villages first. So that's done. I think it takes about 30 minutes. Why are you building a new iron farm? To get iron. Like an hour? No, it's actually faster. I think it's 30 minutes. Will there be a time from the building process? Yeah, yeah. Kinda wanted to release the episode last Sunday, but I don't know. Didn't feel like it. Still one from here. Was the Iron Train is really that fast in 15 minutes? That was actually quite decent then. It was 1.7, and maybe it was different back then. Yeah. Should be enough. Now they need like 1 hour or so. That depends on the size, but I think 32 villages, 1 hour makes sense, yeah. What is Cycroft? I'm here from Genesee. Yeah, welcome. Yeah, it's a technical Minecraft server. It's all about building farms, not so much about aesthetics. Technically, we would also like to do something except building farms, like, yeah, some mini games or something like that, but we haven't really started on that yet. I think building farms is still more fun and there's stuff left to do. Thank you. Oh, come on. Yeah, I wanted to do a boat race. Something like, yeah, Pi released recently, which was a creative map, but definitely want to build something like that in survival at some point. Maybe a horse race as well. Maybe also some simple games at some point. Definitely everything is technical. Maybe not a computer in Minecraft, but who knows, at some point. I'll probably lose interest before I actually start on that. Alright.
Hello.
Hi, Masa. Yeah, I built a horse race in the old server, also with a 7-second display, just give it a time afterwards. Yeah. Oh no! Wait, why does it go back? I think when I go around the corner then I somehow bounce back from the first minecart. Oh, I also forgot to to place the glowstone block again. When the villager has a minecart in the head. It's just a baby villager, but he'll grow up. Okay, kinda didn't pay attention. Is the other one in? Yeah. No, this is not a single player world. Are we not exactly drowning in iron, no? We had a million iron blocks, now we have about 20,000 left. Glowstone on top? I don't think we need a glowstone because the village is so far away. The other one over there also doesn't have a glowstone. Also we have mob spawning basically disabled anyway with the mob switches. The Mesa Core is actually just as fast as this iron farm. About 600 iron per hour. Yeah, that's why the Mesa Core is the perfect beginner farm. Gives you everything. right? Okay, it actually happens. Yeah. Nope. I'm not even sure if I redirected the rails at the top. Ah, damn it. I think we can rebuild it. So the minecart doesn't get stopped. I'm also getting a client lag again on the server. Also, that happened yesterday. It was way worse, but it's a bit annoying. So if we just use that, then I'm quite sure the minecart won't bounce back. Oh, it started on its own. Good. Also, do you have any idea why I have this client lag like yesterday as well on your server? Rego didn't have it, just me. Like, I tried to launch Elytras, took 10 seconds and so on, or open chess.
No idea.
I tried everything yesterday, restart the computer, router, everything.
I have had some issues myself, at least with the Killing Floor 2 server and also Mumble server. So there might be some network issues, but I have no idea what that would be and why it's so intermittent. Actually, I think I also had similar issues.
Also on this server?
Yeah.
Yeah. The Grave like server was completely fine.
Took a little bit of time. And yeah, I have no idea what would cause that. Look into it somehow, but
okay. Yeah, today it's way better than yesterday. There's a question which microphone I have. It's called Samson. I think it was 50 euros. It's probably not the best one. Out of box. Time to meet you, yeah. Yep. Yeah. What mod do I have for macros AFK clicking? Either auto hotkey or tweakeroo. Oh yeah, Master, tweakeroo doesn't have a AFK option, like a tree farm where you want to place saplings all the time.
Yeah, that's on my to-do list.
Okay. Don't forget the roofs at El Mango. Which roof? Roofs protecting from lightning strikes. Can they strike on glass? Yeah, they definitely can. Oh, come on! No, what?
Yeah, the minecarts are so annoying since 1.9. Because the villagers and other mobs can actually steal them, so.
I also getting this client lag again. It's really hard to not launch larger to do anything. Okay. So there's a way you can do it, we'll make it even better. Let's try that the next time. Wait, somebody named the Nitwit Oreo, what? I had a lot of client like 2 days ago before it turned out to be Java. It's maybe my... Oh, my memories! That's probably it. Huh.
That looks normal to me.
Normal? Okay. Thanks, Jimin. Maybe some too. Yeah, but I still assume that's the server somehow, because on the other server it's totally fine. Also played on the Snapshot server today, it was also good. Only having that client issue on the server at the moment. Won't the ladders... Are the ladders for entity cramming, or why did he place ladders there? Does anybody know? So how would I get the villagers in there if there are ladders? For cramming. But how do I get them in there? For pistons, yeah. Can also use vines, yeah, but then it probably still fall on them. Wouldn't it be better if you use vines? Is there a swamp maybe near? Because maybe the mycot can fall through the vines. Is there no swamp? Yeah, it doesn't look like it. Yeah, I'm gonna quickly go to creative to see if we can come up with something. Come on. Maybe it's my client. I should restart. Gonna restart the game really quick. There we go. Do we have a bad connection today? I don't know, it's the issue. Will the activator rails work? Might be an option, yeah. But I was thinking about using pistons. So maybe if you deposit them all here on a rail, break that rail later, push them over. Check those. Yeah, that shouldn't be too hard. think that would work. Two of the ladders are in the way. Let's get a bunch of villagers in there. Okay, we need a bit of delay, I guess. Oh no, that one first, the other way around. Yeah, like that. Yeah, that should work. Then. Okay. Oh, like that is smarter, that should also work. Okay, they're not getting cramped. Perfect. Put a block on top of the ladder, I mean like that. But it should still work. It doesn't matter if it's those other villages. Oops. No, it didn't. Why did it not work? Because of that one block? That was odd. Maybe it was of the baby Pikmin or something like that. That's definitely working. Alright, I think I'm gonna build this. I think it's gonna be fine. 20 villagers. So not even... I don't even need the ladders. I think Ita just did it for the lag improvement. Oh yeah, I want to place a rail here. by the rail, so you can stack the villagers in the minecarts on top of each other. You don't need to run for every single villager. Which music do you use? There's the song command you can use. No, that's the whole point, yeah. The letters, the entity calculations aren't done, yeah. How did he get out there? sorry, we have to kill you. Yes, we have similar issues here. Oh, the village is too tall! Oh no! Didn't think about that. It would have worked if, I don't know, something like a... something small? A baby villager? We could have stacked those. Oh yeah, we also have the minecarts anyway, so we probably should just take out the minecarts. Really? Why? Yeah, but maybe we can get those even in immediately. Don't need to wait even. Just need one repeater? See what happens. Damn it, they're in the block. Ah, now they're in. Okay. I think we got the first ones in. It's good. Yeah, I guess I have to send them one of. To the next one after the other. Yeah, now we have 218 to go. Actually, just remember that we have actually mob cramming 100 in the server. So I wouldn't even need to worry about it.
Didn't you say that you want to at some point donate to the vanilla value?
Definitely, but we need a new nether mob switch first. Do that.
Is there a spot for minecarts in the main storage?
A what?
Spot for minecarts.
Kinda, yeah. The unstackable items. But he removed that sorter. And quickly go to creative. So I let them drop down, it doesn't work. How do we get them all on the rail? Does anybody have an idea? So the idea is to have them all on the same rail. If a rail falls down, then you can have multiple on the same rail, more pistons probably. Kinda need to make something that pushes them over, I guess. So they're parked here, then I push them over. That would work. Damn.
Do they not drop if you have a downward slope on the top?
I'm gonna get stuck in there. If I use a slime block? Nope. Maybe if they would be lower? Let's try more delay. That's why I usually don't do redstone on the stream. I started to see if it's actually possible in the first place. Maybe we can't just push them in from the side. But the timings are completely wrong if I look at this. Oops.
The music is moving.
Okay, put the first one in. I think it just doesn't work. No, it just doesn't work. They bounce back. I guess we could try to activate the rails to get them in the first cell, but then could have done the same already for the ladder system. Was there some kind of trick we could use? What if they had the same height? Can we push them over there? Water streams, maybe? I mean, I can always use the activator rail just to get them out of the cart, then let them drop in somehow. But I hate using activator rails because they're always different. The system I'm here probably is not gonna work on. Then they land on the rail. That is so stupid. Let's just do it the tedious way in survival. Okay, got number 3. Would be nice if we could get those minecarts back. Out of reach. Ha ha ha. Also get the feeling that this system is a bit stupid, maybe we can also improve that. I'm just by having a sloped rail somehow. Which is probably hard to do. Yeah. If you don't... Maybe water could help. Or use a cactus. Ah, not even the cheaty cactus helps here. Okay. Oh yeah, I can have picked up from the corner, true. Yep. I'll try that next. Yep. Ah, das Ding flew in. Goddammit. Ah. Ja, if the light trick can fit in there. That might work. Yep. Let's get two. Did it just go through a portal?
Yeah. Oh.
Fix the portals merging.
Yeah, you pretty much always know when someone uses portal.
Okay, six.
Where was this tool, the tool storage on the server? Was it at the Guardian Farm?
At the Guardian Farm, yeah. Oops. Oh, he made it. Okay. Eight. Thank you. 10. That's the Iron Stream by Ito. Best Iron Farm. It's just a test iron farm basically for the big one. I'm gonna build a 1536 village iron farm. A breeder still running, okay. I'm not sure how much Red Rago has still in it. So it's probably another 50k. Hey, Kunja Joa. Awesome. New descent. So 18, 2 more, and then we got it. Yeah, it's the small one blocking it. Yeah, true, we could build 100 of those. Thanks, Trevor. 2 bits. Okay, that's 20, right? Looking. Now there's probably some item entities. Try to pick those up. Yeah, that's 20. Okay. Oh. Okay. I guess we have to push that block in. And we're missing one glass, of course. Okay, now we just need to fix the last few issues here with the farm, like filling the containers, and I'm missing some water. Threw away my buckets. No hydrated bottle, but I'm drinking anyway. Hi Billy. Oh, the Klein Lake, what's going on? Jamin, it has been a while. Maybe 2-3 weeks? Farm won't break if it's deloaded? Depends. Depends. But we're also gonna make a new chunk loading system here, so we actually don't need it to build it in the spawn chunks and it won't break, hopefully. Alright, now the container blocks. Let's check. As you can see here, the farm still works despite unloading the world a few times. So it is completely filled up. Thanks a lot, Jamin. Then here we have one stick. Stick and 10. Yeah, look what's going on with the client. The clicking, clicking, nothing happens. Okay. Isn't it supposed to be locked somehow? I think the sand block needs to be pushed up. Oh, wait, let's check the next few container blocks. I guess here we just have a single item. What else would it be? Really? Gonna drown the villager? Oh no, did it just go up? Ah, here at the bottom, we have this construct. Okay. One item in the topper. Then one in the dropper.
Hello, hello.
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 Okay, one here. I think it might be it. The hopper next to the dropper. Yeah, there's an item in there now. Okay, seems like we got it all now. If not, then we can still fix it afterwards, I guess. It has 16. I think the killing system also is not prepared completely. Remember right, we need some lava maybe? Well, oh, we have golems! Okay. Ah, is there maybe a little lava lake somewhere? Sometimes you get them above ground. There would be a single lava source. Could be enough. Wait, where am I supposed to place this now? Ah, on top of the glass panes. Okay, I think yeah, one single, so should be enough. Okay. Yeah, the ore works, but it's a single village iron farm, basically. Okay, let's clean up and then we can try it out. I'm not sure if we want to build a collection system immediately. Okay, maybe put a hopper there in the chest so we don't waste anything, but probably doesn't matter too much. Does anybody know where to start and stop it? I think there must be a button somewhere, but I don't know. Top in the logic, okay. Not sure if I placed it. Does not quite look like it. But I have the schematics still, not the coordinates. Let's just check in the world. Oh, hier. Okay. It was a wooden button. Alright, so let's start the Iron Stream. Probably not much to see, we don't have that villager marker mod, but yeah, there's stuff going on, definitely. Stuff going on, yeah. For Spigot, don't use this farm. Yeah, definitely not. Don't play Spigot, and if you play Spigot, don't use any redstone. Thanks a lot for the bit. Alright, awesome. Guess now we have to play the waiting game. I was thinking about depositing a bot here. And then we can actually start with the... Thanks a lot for the bits, Trevor. I think it was 14 in total. Should take 30 minutes. If you really want, we can also place some hoppers, I guess. So we don't waste the first batch of iron. I think I brought some. Okay. Just gonna summon a bot so this stays loaded. But it's mostly for testing. Dropper time is correct, I hope.
Hey, Mango, I think Carpet Client has village detection on the F7 key.
Okay. I think we have here.
Yeah, looks like it.
Cool.
It doesn't work with large numbers of villages though. It like overloads it, tries to send something to the client that's too large. And so it just doesn't every time. Like the 240 village iron farm won't show villages. Mm-hmm. I think the limit is like a megabyte or something.
Oh, yeah, I think it's working. There's the second village.
Yep. Looks like there's three, the yellow, the blue, and the green.
Yep, whoops. Dirt pig, sure. I don't think the breeder is gonna affect it. It's out of range. Oh, they're all merchant one. Can you see somehow how many? No, they don't. They shouldn't merge, right? Is it wrong?
The villages.
Now we only have the yellow left.
Hmm.
Is it wrong somehow?
Oh. Yeah, it's... You should be able to see multiple colors there.
Yeah. I think it's fading somehow.
You know where the water flows over the glass on top of the doors? Let's take a look at that really quick.
That one?
Just a second, let the stream catch up.
Oh, I forgot to place water here, right?
Yeah.
Well, it's okay to do that, but it shouldn't affect it.
All of those pistons should be extended. Did you put items in the droppers up there?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Oh wait, no, they shouldn't be extended.
I think it merged somehow.
I think so.
Thanks a lot for the 20 bits. We miss it. What was it? 5 bits from Taukind. Thanks a lot. Okay. Maybe I did it wrong. Let's maybe check again. Quite sure there's supposed to be water here. That's why it's not working.
Maybe.
Oh, they should all be extended, yeah. Ton of water here. Oh, okay. I messed up the water, that's why it wasn't working. Thanks a lot, Kim, for the 50 bits.
I think those are only extended because when they extend it lets the light go through, which registers as a valid village. And the water blocks enough skylight that it doesn't register. And that's how it's able to build.
I think I can just press the button again and fix it by doing that.
Yeah, I think so. I think you still need another water bucket on the other side too.
I just placed it wrong here.
Ah.
I hope it's one of those farms that you can just restart again while it's building already. F7. No! Still disappeared. Oh no, we got one on the other side now. Ah, that's stupider. Stupid. Yeah, that seems like it's still not working.
Oh, there it goes. I think it just, I think the reset process just finished.
Okay.
So. Yeah, because I think it has to give it enough time for the villages to deconstruct, and then it'll start building again. But I'm not sure about in the middle of a building process. Yeah, I'm pretty much a big iron farm noob as well, so.
Wait, do we have a giant blue village now? Oh, I think the breeder could mess with it. Look at that. Right?
As long as you don't have lines connecting, I think it should be fine.
Okay.
Because I think villager door detection is 32 blocks.
Someone got away. Why is this still running? Did I actually put like 50,000 bread in there?
If you just break the doors underneath, it'll stop running.
Does it? Yeah, it's still running. Stupid. Rego, I thought Rego need like 20 villagers and he brings 50,000 bread over.
Rego. What is that clock?
It's a comparator clock, probably to Spence's bread.
You get quite a nice view from the mountain on the north side.
That one? Oh yeah. I think now we have different lines here, I think. That means we have multi-village farm now, yeah.
Yeah, I think there should be one color per row of doors.
Mm-hmm. That seems to work now. The blue village is messing things up. Yeah, okay.
So it's just building. It's fine. Okay. Or it should be fine. Yeah, as villagers get moved around, that blue sphere gets moved, and then it'll eventually join the others. Or it should. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's part of Copic Land. Village doors, golem cage, population cage. Yeah, there's a lot of options. But I never messed with that yet. Bounty box options. Oh, that's actually really cool. I never used it so far.
Yeah, I think lots of stuff changed in 1.13 with the villages because they just changed some of the iteration algorithms, but they changed or reverted them again. So in 1.13.1, I think most of it should be back.
Yeah, I can only recommend to not play 1.13. Wait until 1.13.1 is out.
Yeah.
Should take 26 minutes, maybe 20 minutes more. Not sure if the golem spawning rates are crazy yet, probably not. might get one every minute at the moment, or every 45 seconds. It's definitely working already. 9 iron! Yay! What's the next one? Yeah, you can actually see the progress. I think this means we have maybe 30%. Yeah, I know. This was a bit stupid that they made the bucket fish count towards the mob cap. We found that already out. We told it to dock, and yeah, I kind of used it on the Hermitcraft, so if somebody follows that. Yep, 16 villages. Oh, there you go. Probably, I hope I didn't spoil it, but kind of obvious, right? Gonna build a permaloader next. Probably underground again. That's why we might need to make a tunnel bore. One weird trick to stop fish spawning, 1.13, yeah. Yep, it's actually enough. Just have a couple fish buckets in the spawn chunks. And that's your water mob switch.
Is it just for fish or all water mobs?
All water mobs. The mob cap for fish is now... not for fish. For all water mobs is now 15. Previously it was 5 when you only had the squid.
Which cap are the dolphins in?
Squid, fish and dolphin. Actually, would have probably not have the dolphins despawn, would have made them animals or passive mobs, would have worked as well. Just generate them with the world. Oh, Jamin, thanks for 105 bits. What, is this a big ad?
No, it's just a bunch that I've had stocked up.
It's Twitch integration, yeah. But it's not default Minecraft, it's a mod that I have, light loader mod.
Remember when there actually used to be Twitch integration with Minecraft?
Yeah, it was in 1.7?
Yeah,
took it out a while ago.
Does it still exist?
Minecraft 1.7? What?
I mean, the Twitch stuff in the middle.
No.
What if it would still work if you downgraded to 1.7 and tried it?
That would be interesting, yeah. Probably not, because stuff changes and... Yeah. Oh yeah, it's still raised. It's looking like it's half built already. Ride Escape also has the other API change since then. But this was definitely more effort than I thought it would be. I think I spent probably 5 hours on building this, and I had a little bit of help here.
I might also need to build this iron farm on my server, because I only have like 2 village passive farm at the moment in the spawn chunks.
Oh, it's all the holes here. God damn it.
I guess you could say your iron farm's built on holy ground.
Ah, 50% is done. Yeah, but definitely won't get any crazy raids. So remember, Regu's farm with 256 villages that we had in the spawn chunks, that was quite quick, so they always had golems in there, but don't think it's gonna happen with this one. Probably nothing to make this place look nice. Maybe with the big farm that the TDL is gonna build. Might even make a perimeter for it, not sure yet. A nice iron block perimeter, that'd be awesome. Iron walls, iron floor, everything out of iron. Wouldn't that be awesome?
Would an iron farm actually benefit from a perimeter, or would it just be for lag improvement?
Don't think it would benefit. Yeah, the old iron farm at spawn is 256, yeah. But it's decommissioned, we don't want to use a farm in the spawn chunks anymore. So we took out all the hoppers, I think it had like 800-900 hoppers. Killed all the villagers. Obviously you could make it run again, but... better build some new farms, it's been a while. 3.5 years since we built that thing. Do we just need the client for that? Really? You don't need carpet mod? Both, yeah.
You need both. It doesn't work in single player.
The server needs to send the village data.
Yeah, because I think all the village data is saved on the server, so I think you need the mod itself on the server to fetch the data for you. And then the client draws the lines. That's my guess anyways, I don't know.
Yeah.
Panic actually bring over a pig, or was this just one of the naturally generated ones from this place?
I don't know. There was one pig also in the nether.
Yeah, so we reached the second half. Maybe 40% left.
So are we removing this rail line completely?
Yeah, why not? What is making your blocks not emit any particles when breaking? That's useful mod. I think I'm kinda too lazy today to start on digging. Let's just watch the chunk loading below the iron farm.
Ah.
I'm too lazy today. Yeah, let's just watch until the iron farm is done, see if it all works correctly. Then we'll start the quarry again.
Get to watch some villages being built before we get to watch some villages being torn down.
Oh yeah. Almost a stick. Still a glass pillar. I think it's a really good farm for single player and pretty much every server really. Except you like to build with iron blocks and might need something for quicker.
Yeah, I think this is 15,000 something per 24 hours.
Different enough for pistons and hoppers.
Yeah. And since the reset time is so low, you can pretty much build it anywhere. If you have an account to AFK there, you don't even really need a chunk loading grid.
That is true. But you said we're gonna build it for the test.
Yeah. I'm just saying if anybody watching wants to build it. It's a nice farm.
Mm-hmm.
It's the first one we built on the Patreon server.
Oh yeah, what do we have now? The TDL?
Yeah, we have the FE Mini.
Okay.
That's a 240.
Okay. Is that enough?
It's,
or are you gonna go larger?
It's enough. I think we're gonna stick with the one we've got for now.
Mm-hmm.
That's, I think, 9,000 items per hour. So yeah. So that includes poppies. I don't know the exact iron per hour.
Yeah, hey, Surgeon. The farm is doing great. I think maybe 7 or 8 more minutes, it should have built all the villages. Not sure if you can upgrade this easily to 32. Probably not. Thank you. Like this side is already no. It's mirrored basically. Oh, okay. There's like two doors left. Can this farm detect if a village stack breaks and start an automatic reset sequence? No. Are there concepts for that even? Not sure how you would detect it. Can maybe detect the incoming golems encountered somehow? And if you fall below a certain threshold, just restarts? Oh, counter drops, yeah, that would also work, I guess. Ah, it's still building. Sort of be done. Actually, what we could do before the AFK quarry stream is Besumt and I were working on a dead coral farm today and we've almost finished it. Maybe we can do that on stream.
You say dead coral?
Yeah, actually a dead coral farm.
Okay.
But it's super hard to make one. You would be surprised how hard it is. It's insane. It's obviously nobody ever will need a dead coral farm, but in case you need a double chest of dead coral items, I mean, what you gonna do?
Yeah.
No, it's all renewable.
Or if you're
trying to... None of the landscape gets destroyed.
If you're trying to get a double chest of every type of dead coral, you know.
Is it done?
Looks like it.
Looks like it. Oh, awesome. Pretty lines, yeah. And already 2 stacks, so it's also really quick. Thanks, Damon. Yeah, I think Besumt was up to it. I think I'm gonna switch to 1.13 and we'll try to finish the dead coral farm. And then, yeah, might not take that long. Then we start the quarry. Watch the village been taken out.
You gonna summon a bot first?
Yeah? I already did.
Oh.
But I'm not sure if I should even have the iron farm running while quarry is running. It's probably a bad idea.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. Okay, Wumpets 13 is open. Okay, maybe we should explain first why is it so hard to make a dead coral farm? The issue is seagrass, it ruins everything again. So you might notice since snapshot from last week, if you bone meal water in a warm ocean biome, you can get seagrass plus dead corals. Alright, now in order to get the dead corals that we want, we need to remove the water. First idea was to have a lot of dispensers on top and suck in all the water. But then we found out that this doesn't work with the seagrass. So if I try to bucket the seagrass, waterlog block doesn't work. It does work with the corals on the other hand. But yeah. You can't really get rid of the water if the seagrass is blocking it. And if you would try to use pistons or whatever, then you would break everything, so yeah. No chance to get this to work. Then methods try to make a converter farm. I think the idea was to place dead coral here, and a normal coral here, and then break it with dual wielding. Not sure if this works. Yeah, supposed to have a block pushed up in front of you, did it break a snow layer, and so on. But this is probably too complicated. And also it's not really that convenient to use. Then, luckily, Bisumto actually found out something really nice. We could use sand to detect, kinda detect, the seagrass. So if you place a seagrass on, a sand block on seagrass, it falls down, replace it. Do the same with the corals. Doesn't fall down. Alright. And that's why we came up with this one here. This would be basically our farm concept. As you can see, it's really complicated. The player would stand here and take out the dead corals with some sick touch tool. And in order to get the dead corals, we have to push over sand, let it drop down. Okay, let's do that. Up. Okay. Here this block or the sand block stayed at the top. And now we need to push over the observers again that power the sand block, which trigger this dispenser array. But only the spots where we actually have water. Okay. So if we get rid of that last water here, then the coral would actually die once we remove the water from the waterlock blocks. Okay, let's activate this. Then the next step was to get the sand back to the other side. So we need to activate this row here. And then this system here that pulls the sand up and over. And now here we have only the dead coral left. And this dispenser has sucked in water, the other ones didn't. Alright, now we need to remove the water here. This is basically the water regeneration system for later. Okay, coral is dead, now the player will come along. Mine it. And in the next step, we have to dispense the water again. So that's why here we detect if we have a filled bucket or an empty bucket. And have some blocks extending here at the bottom. So now if you give a signal to this line, then only the trapdoors with the corresponding filled water bucket dispensers would activate. So you can see here. Only the one in the middle. And now we need to regenerate the rest of the water as well. So we need to activate those things again. And then open the trapdoors. So now we have water sources all over the place again, regenerated. So you need water sources obviously for the Spencer system for the bone meal, and now we close them again. We also activate the dispenser in the middle in order to get the new seagrass and coral. Okay, now we have time to read chat. Unfortunately, not Twitch integration 1.13. Yeah, 100% useless, for sure. Wouldn't it be easy to just make a coral farm and a coral to the dead coral converter? Yeah, that's what Mephas tried, but it's not that easy. Just gonna go through chat real quick. Now do the logic, yeah, exactly. Yeah, Mephas already tried to make a dead coral converter, but it's also hard in case you want to AFK it. Obviously, if you, I don't know, don't like to AFK it, just do everything manually and it's really easy. Just place the corals, wait and break it, I mean, okay. But if you want to do the AFK, it's really, really hard, because you would need to hold down right and left, and that's why you can't even place them in a row. You would immediately break them again if you have a tool. Any tool is fine. God damn it, my tool is always filled with stupid stuff. I'm just gonna quickly show what happens if you would try this. So if I hold on right and left, then yeah, this wouldn't work. So what you can do is place a single one, then you need to push up a lock, a block immediately until the coral dies, so has enough time. Then you need to remove the block again, but the player actually needs to break a block, otherwise you can't place a coral anymore. This is similar to the leaf farm we did a while ago, so it's getting really complicated and it's probably not worth it just to convert a single coral every 10 seconds. But it's better to do the automatic farm if you want to get decent rates. This would be 300, maybe 300 coral items per hour. And with the other one, you can probably get better rates. Can observers detect coral death? Yes, they can. Oh, thanks a lot for the 100 bits, Matthew. Alright, so Besumte, what do we need to do now in order to make this automatic? A backup? So we make a structure block? Yeah, that's a good idea. Oh yeah, assume this is the command expert, you can do it. Thanks for the host, Nessie. Yeah, the problem with this system is here also that it's not that super fast, so we probably need multiple ones of those. So player's probably sitting in a minecart here, it's getting stopped every so often, and then moves to the right. Oh, thanks a lot, Jason, for the 3 months free sub. Alright, player's gonna probably stop here and take out the dead coral, then move to the next unit and so on. Get some decent speed. Do corals duplicate? No. Can only get them with the bone meal method. Thanks a lot, Jamin. Okay. Oh yeah, everything breaks if you do a structure block, obviously. That's really so convenient about carpet mod that you don't get the block updates. Okay, maybe we can also redo this here. This was our 3 game tick pulse generator. You need a 3 game tick pulse generator in order to power those sticky pistons here really quickly, because the observer would otherwise always power the block even if it's on top of a seagrass, because it takes a while until they fall down. That's why we have to retract the observers again and then power it again in order to actually power the remaining sand blocks. Not sure if this is there even a better 3 game tick pulse generator. Have you tried maybe with the leaf mechanics? Probably not. Maybe if somebody knows a nice 3 game tick pulse generator, let me know. Maybe we can use some kind of a butt for it. What we used was a instant repeater setup. Maybe we can build it up again. So the idea is to give this sticky piston here a short pulse. If I give this sticky piston a short pulse, then the block is immediately dropped, instantly pushed over. And then use another piston here in order to send the block back after 3 ticks. Okay, I think Bisunto has a better version. Okay, what are we doing here? This is 1 tick, 2 ticks. Yeah, this is better. Okay, just want to show you that this one also works. But this one is better. Okay, so we have 1 game tick here, 2 ticks there. Yeah, better one. Can definitely use it. Would it be better even use a redstone block? Why wouldn't the torch? Oh, the log. Derp. Obviously. Okay. Maybe I should actually check what's the range of the player in. So here we try to make it 5 long, not sure if that even is an option. Might need to go down to 4. Yeah, I think we need to cut one block off. Can't even reach the last one. And great if it works. Where should we cut the block? Probably here. Probably has to stop the player somehow. How could we do that? So is the option of a fence gate? That would work. Yeah, what's up, Bison 2? Yeah, but we kinda need it in a row, right? I mean, Micah's then supposed to stop here again. I mean, we definitely want more than one station, right? Or should we just make a proof of concept, since nobody's gonna be stupid enough to build this anyway? Maybe let's do the proof of concept first. Maybe that's probably the best. If they fix the seagrass bug, then we can make the simple form anyway. Okay, let's do this one, yeah. Let's do the slow form. Kinda need to do the same on the other side, I guess. Just to keep the player there for a while. Yeah, true, it seems easier. Okay. Probably also want to expense that stuff. Okay, let's start wiring it. Doesn't matter if it's gonna be huge. It's always better to build a working version first and then compact it later. Whoops. I'm just gonna try this if the timing is alright. Send. Wait, did it actually work? No, it didn't. Bit more delay. That'd have been prettier if you didn't have it late. Okay, let's try again. Oh, it doesn't work. Presume to look, they dropped the observers. I think this system doesn't work. Yeah, look. I also know why. No? Why? Yeah. Should be 3 ticks. But that definitely before like that. Looks like 3. We can definitely use this, I mean it works, look. Just small leaves, I guess. I guess we have to do some testing at some point. The leaf timings. Definitely have thought this would be 3. But for now it works. We can also make that part easy again, just the 4 tick repeater, that would be nice. I think it worked. Yep, this is dry. Rest has sent. Yep. Okay. Then. Just keep wiring it. Here we can use a button. Or just more dust. Might be easier. Some delay. Oh, what we need to powder the ones on the back first here. Assume to write those ones. Yeah, okay. Hmm. guess it's an option. Yeah. Need some delay here already. And then we need to add a button here. Oh, just seeing here. That we should have maybe moved this over a block. Bis um to. We need to power this. But we're better to have it here. Yeah, it doesn't work if I have to redirect it. Not sure if this is this interesting for stream what we're doing here. This is the first time actually doing designing on stream. So it's about a dead coral form we're trying to do. Live creative redstone, not interesting. Yeah, maybe do it every few months. Alright, so we had to move this over because this piston was powered by QC and I had to redirect it because we had a observer output here, a repeater output here. I didn't want. So the idea is that we kinda now can power this block. Doesn't matter, before we had to redirect it. Alright. Yeah, let's try this. Okay, so I'm just resetting it. Okay, let's go. Ah, I didn't push. Ah, it's not connected. Yeah, no, 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 the other way. Like that. What is it? First we pull and then push, yeah. But look out. Not sure, maybe the timings could be sharper, but yeah, I don't care this time. Okay, now we need to remove the water. Yep, this is not wired yet. How should we do it? I think it's okay if you do it like that. Just some rails. Can make it instant. Why would we make it instant? Oh, you mean we can do it in the first place? Yeah. All right. Can now this one get triggered twice? Do it manually this time. Okay. the block is powering this. Oh yeah, good. So this wiring at the bottom is for the trapdoors. Yep. Should we quickly reset the water? Oh, okay. This is a problem because it would get activated twice between the flip-flop unless maybe we get it from here. Should we do it like that? Not just put a trapdoor here, whatever, another dust. I mean, should be fine. It's better before? Okay. Okay. All right. In the background, yeah, this is our warm ocean snapshot world. We made the fish farm here. Let's reset it. Let's try again. Okay, coral about to die. And what do we actually need to do next now? Send a signal to the bottom here. Probably launch the player. Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah. I don't know, this probably requires some delay. Should we just try with a lot of repeaters here? Not good? Opposite direction? Oh yeah, that would be better. Mm-hmm. Oh, so I kind of need to select a tool that maybe doesn't break the comparators. Could be maybe protected somehow if we use a silk touch shovel and place trapdoors or whatever. Might be a good idea. Oh, different block. We'll see. Oh yeah, Besumtu, how do we even collect the stuff? Yeah. We could have a hopper micro below, but it would pick up bone meal from the dispenser. Phew. Flush it over, what? Well, why not? So we activate the trapdoor here in the back first, flush it over. God, this farm is so complicated. Maybe? make an item filter using a hopper minecart activate a rail combo instead of a regular hopper. Oh, Vince has a good idea. Could I actually use hopper minecarts? But it doesn't work because it's 5 different coral types. What is it? Yeah. No, it's 5 different coral. Dead coral. So we have dead brain, bubble, fire, horn, tube. You're not sure if you even get the fans. Never. Okay. Then it's even 10. Yeah, I don't think this would work. So many different items. Worked? Worked. Okay. Keep in mind we also need to empty the dispensers, the ones that are full. Hopper card inside the dispenser on top. Oh, TT is a good trick. Yeah, that could work. Never done it, but let's see. How can I get them in the block again? It was something with curved rails. How did that work? What was the trick? Ah. Was it like that? Yeah, something like that. Okay, I assume to has it. Oh, it's probably even easier than. Okay. Alright. So let's try it out. We can have a bone meal here. Oh yeah, slap. True. Now I get it. So now we need to hop the card here. I think that the minecart needs to be a little bit lower on standing on soul sand. Now I get it. So we need to remove the other blocks. Yeah, like this. Now we can add the hopper. Ah, okay. Never done it before, but it's a really nice trick, I guess. So if we fill something in the minecart. Ah, that is an awesome trick. Thanks, TT. Does seagrass grow on corals on hoppers? Assume not. Can't probably, yeah, I can't even place it on it. Okay. I think then we just need to fill up the rest with minecarts. Yeah, from the credit field, you can just summon them, I guess. Oh, I hate this so much, that it gives the exact values now instead of the center of the block. Why? Okay, that should work. Yeah. I was just wondering if you maybe could actually somehow also refill the dispenser or just build it somewhere else. There's a dropper here and from the side, maybe somehow. Yeah, let's not worry about it. What's up? I'm not sure what I want to show me. Life is just always mysterious and surprising. You never know what's around the next corner. Ah, now I get it. Okay. But then we kinda. Yeah, the stuff doesn't grow in hoppers, we seem to. Put it on there, it doesn't grow. Oh, the coral would work. What? The coral works. Oh god, this is such. No, this is so much easier then. Oh, what we actually did is so much easier if we just place a lot of hoppers. Oh, come on. This is almost too stupid. Yeah. Oh god, this is actually an awesome discovery. Completely useless what we did. Yeah, thanks Loki, 500 bits. Okay, now this form will be stupidly easy. But it's probably a bug. It definitely also increases your coral rates, I guess. Yeah, it's so much better. Can we finish the old one? We might actually need it at some point in case the wrong bug gets fixed there. If you really want to finish it, why not? So the idea would be now just to have a lot of dispensers here at the top. Oh yeah. Just suck up all the water, then the coral dies, player goes by in a minecart, breaks the dead corals, it's immediately collected by the hoppers even. Dispense the water again, bone meal it, and repeat. Thanks, Jamin, for your last 50 bits. Alright, I don't think we need to do it on stream, this is kind of trivial. Let's say go back to the survival world and start the quarry. Can you make the clip, please? Sure, Jamin can maybe do that, or I've actually never made a clip. I think everybody can clip, yeah. Yeah, I think everybody can do that. Okay, I'm changing back to 1.12. I'm definitely gonna upload the live stream. I should maybe quickly turn off OBS and turn it back on again. Stream maybe, so we don't have all of that on YouTube. There's also kind of limit, a 10-hour limit on YouTube. Tookie says, just for having Jamin as a moderator, 25 bits. Thanks. Music. I'm gonna restart it. No, it's back. Okay. Okay, farm is definitely working. Okay, let's kill the bot here. That pig must have wandered over from the overworld. I don't think anybody put it there. Stream is a bit laggy, true, yeah. Yeah, we kinda used our last iron for this tunnel. Actually learned how expensive those iron trapdoors are. Like a half an iron block. I think it's actually one of the best looking piston bolts. Especially like the trapdoor walls here. So we use the flying machine in order to make that. Those are all open trapdoors. Doesn't work anymore, 1.13. What about roofs over villager cells? Yeah, I have to talk to Eater if this is actually a big problem. Jamin says, I really like the Guardian farm Piston Bolt on a Patreon server. I've seen an amazing Piston Bolt with a lot of Nether Brick. Maybe we should check out the Patreon server a bit again. Don't think I've seen the Guardian farm one. Could I actually quick do that before we start the quarry? Oh, they don't have the IP because I deleted my server list again. Ah, never mind. Do it another time. Piston Bolts versus Blue Ice Roads. Piston Bolts, in my opinion, because don't need to steer the boat. Also, it's way nicer to have something automated, even if it's not that fast. Yeah, IP's in Discord, but we need to paste it in, and I don't know. Don't want to do that. We'll just do it the next time. Yeah, I could also turn off OBS, obviously, and do it real quick and then turn it on again. Too lazy. Just do it the next time. Thanks a lot, Franzaya, for the 3 months in a row. Thanks a lot. Okay, so preparing now everything for the AFK stream. Because this is gonna be like the highlight, you can say, of the whole quarry. We're gonna quarry a village. After that, there's really nothing interesting in a way anymore. It's mostly savanna, mesa biome, ocean biome, so it's kind of a highlight. Not really, but plan to stream this tonight for 8 to 10 hours. I think that's how long it should take. It's probably gonna be the last AFK quarry stream. Yeah, the quarry has done amazing progress, as you can see. We've moved 940 blocks forward, got about 10 million items from that already. Quarry crashed maybe 4 or 5 times. Still having an issue that we don't know what's causing it with the mine shafts. Some odd block combination has potential to break the quarry, but it doesn't happen very often. Are you moving the AFK account that loaded the quarry manually? No, I restart the server every 3 or 4 days anyway, and then I just have to resummon them. So they're not getting moved somehow. So I'm checking every day, probably twice on the quarry. Is there a mineshaft coming up? Oh yeah, that would be a problem. I'm checking spectator mode. Doesn't look like it. Nope, no mineshaft ahead. So unless the water breaks the quarry, we should be safe. Yeah, that's actually the other issue we're having with the quarry. The walls and ocean, yeah, this is a bit of an issue. Get smaller and smaller. Yeah, here I actually replaced some sand and placed sandstone instead already today. So this should be safe, but yeah. Generally, oceans and yeah, sand that falls down is also a big issue. Yeah, I already added the blocks. I'm gonna stand next to the village, AFK. In creative mode probably, so the villagers also pathfind. But stay in spectator, they probably wouldn't do anything. So maybe I'll stand... sure, maybe here. That would be good. Maybe if I wake up in 4 or 5 hours, I can also move it a little bit. I think this would be a good view. Okay. Then I'm just gonna stop the stream real quick just to split up the files between AFK stream and what we did with the Iron Farm and the creative world. But I'm gonna start again right away.